With the iterator, you can split arrays into multiple bundles of data so that you can process each of them separately. So that looks like this. So over here we have the iterator. This is what it looks like in IntegraMAT. And then here on the left, we have a bundle of data with an array in it. And in case you didn't know, an array is basically a special type of item. So for example, here we have an email array, and then we just have like multiple values into it. And then what we do is we go into the iterator, and then basically what that iterator does, it is splitting the items of this array into multiple bundles of data. So this one bundle of data with an array in it with three items becomes three different bundles of data. And it sounds maybe really taggy, but it's actually really simple. So let's just dive into IntegraMAT and then we'll show you how it works. So over here we have a scenario with a webhook module. So this webhook module got some data. So we get a company name, the amount of employees, and then an array with email addresses. So the name of the array is email. And then we have four elements in that array, each of them an email address. And what I want to do is I want to send an email in this example to each of those people in that array. But by default, the difficulty is that when you map an item in this array, it's only going to map the first item. Let me demonstrate that so that you see what I mean. So let's send an email to that person, right? So here, send an email, and then we want to map the to. And then over here, what we want to do is we go to the array, then you do this drop down, and then over here you see that we have the first element of that array. You can see with that number one over there. Then I click here, add, then I add some random subject, click here, okay. Click save, we click here, then run once to get some data again. So then you see that we get the same set of data, and an email has been sent to emmadoe@gmail.com and not to the other people in this array, because by default you only map the first element of the array. It is also possible to map another element of the array. You can, for example, also hover this and then change this to number two. And then now, if I do the same thing again, then you will see that it's going to get the second element of that array. So we got the data. So here you see that the second element of our array is Vera Doe. So this email now has been sent to veradoe@gmail.com. So basically, if you would want to send an email to all these four people, what you could do is you could simply create this, right? You can say here, okay, I want to send this to the first element of the array, the second element of the array, the third element of the array, and then the fourth element of the array. But the issue is that you maybe not always know how many items we have in the array. Maybe you get a different data set and then we get only maybe two elements or items in our array, or maybe even 200, and then you don't want to create 200 modules to repeat the same process over and over again, right? So that's why we're going to use the iterator to split that array into multiple bundles of data so that we do not have to create a ton of modules. So then we're going to remove this over here, and then we're going to add an iterator. And the iterator module is actually really simple. So over here, you only have one option, and it is to map the array. So you go in here with your cursor, then this panel will show up, and then you look for the array that you want to map. And an array, little trick, always has these two brackets inside of it. And then I put that in here, and then I click here, okay. And then just to demonstrate what happens now, I'll already click here, run once, so that you can see what happens. So then here we got this data set. So again, here four elements in our array. And then now you will see that the iterator split the array over here, so you can see it, into four different bundles of data. So here you see value, and then here Emma Doe, Vera Doe, John Doe, Lara Doe. Now then in the next step, you see why that is going to be handy. So I will send another email. So here, send an email. Then we map the to field. And then instead of using the webhook data, we're going to use the data from the iterator. And then you want to make sure to add here the value. Then I click here, add. And then we add a random subject, here the content, I click here, okay, click save, click run once, process the existing. So this is the data that we got. Then the iterator split this into four different bundles of data. And then you can already see here with this number four in this bubble that this module was basically executed four times. And then you can also see over here that we have four operations, and each operation was an email that was sent to one of the people in that array. So this is why it's really super duper handy, because you do not have to specify in advance how many elements there are in the array. It's just going to split every element in the array into a separate bundle, and then it will be processed into the modules afterwards. And then I have another cool example to show you. So imagine you have maybe an email module or a Gmail module that is watching for emails with attachments, and you want to upload all the attachments of that email to maybe Google Drive. So what you need to do then is you need again to iterate the attachments. So over here you see that we have an email with three different attachments. We have here meeting notes, we have a picture, and we have an invoice. But if we just say here again Google Drive and then upload a file, and then we want to say here, okay, we want to select from the list, we want to upload this to my quick upload folder. And if we then map here the source file, if I do it like this, so here we go to attachments, then we want to map the file name and the data, right? So here, file name, and then over here, we want to add the data. Then again, you see here this number one, right? So that means that only the first element of our attachments array will be uploaded to our Google Drive folder. Let me demonstrate that. So here we're going to get a new email with some attachments. So then here you see this is the email we got. So again, we have three attachments with meeting notes, an invoice, and a picture. And you see that a file has been uploaded to our Google Drive. But this time, if I refresh this page, you'll see that only the first element was uploaded to our Google Drive, which in this case was meetingnotes.pdf. But we want to upload all of them, right? So that's why we iterate the attachments as well. So I will unlink this, and then I'm going to add another module. We type in here iterator, we have flow control, iterator, and then we insert the array we want to iterate. So over here, I look for attachments, and then again, you see the little bracket over here, right? I click here, okay. And then here we are going to connect this. And then instead of using the variables from our email module, we use the variables from our iterator. So the simplest way is to just say here, flow control iterator, then it will just get all the files from that. Or we can also map it, and then you see over here that we have the file name and the data name. So if I click here now, okay, if I click save, and then if I quickly remove this, move to bin, and then we're going to run this once. So the email we got, again, has three different attachments. Then we iterated this into three different bundles. So each element of our attachments array becomes its own bundle. And then you see now that three files have been uploaded in three different operations. So if I now go over here, refresh the page, you see now that we have three different files. So now you learned how to split arrays into multiple bundles of data with the iterator. But did you know it's also possible the exact other way around with the aggregator? So if you watch this tutorial over here, you will also learn how that works. And if you have any questions about this, just let me know in the comments below.